disappeared into the floor of the Pacifica. And you go from there to napkin sketches, to whiteboard sessions, brainstorming. Eventually you make a 3D virtual model in the computer-assisted design environment. That's where the bulk of the development is done, is on the computer. We'll go from there to prototypes, and then eventually you've got blueprints, and those blueprints are for the actual components. And once you have the components, of course, they get fastened to each other and you have a vehicle. There's a lot of components. There's 2,000 to 3,000 parts that make up a car. And a lot of them, you don't even know they're there. There's brackets that hold the trim in place. There's the structure inside the steering wheel. There's the seatbelt routing. All this stuff takes tremendous amounts of thought and effort to get it just right. So the example I gave is the three rows of seats in the Pacifica. At times, there would have been over 120 people involved in designing those seats, and probably over 100,000 hours of development time in the seats. We did 1,200 hours of that here at ARDC. Mm-hmm. And reason
you worked along with the magnet people and the
I believe some of the people here did. I wasn't actually on that project, I was on different projects, but I do know other people that were here that were absolutely working in the seats and development of early concepts. And so we put all that effort, of course, into it, all that thought and energy, so that when the customer gets it, they don't have to put in the thought and energy. It becomes an intuitive product, and that's the hallmark of good design, of course, is that they don't have to put a second thought into it. It just works like as if they always owned it, as if it always worked that way. And so here at ARDC, very much part of the development process, we design parts. We also do a lot of the virtual testing of the parts. That is, we, in the computer environment, put them under load, make sure that they're strong enough, they're durable enough, and that's before a prototype is even made. And that's a very big part of the development process. We're also involved in cutting edge new ideas, things that have never been put on cars before. So that's a fun process because it requires a lot of creativity. And it's also a daunting process because you've got no historical data to look off of. I can't look at anybody else's vehicles. I can't look at our own that had this feature before. It's brand new. So I had a project a few years back, and I was asked to make this panel, and I had to kind of raise up and move and then move again. And we wanted to make it as simple and robust as possible, hopefully just a single motor that would do this. And at first I was a little bit daunted. I was kind of grasping it. It was a very blank slate. Didn't know where to start. And then I had the light bulb experience. I thought, you know, I've made things like this in Lego. And so I worked with Lego since I was a little kid all the way up to adult years. And so I brought my Lego into work. Got a lot of funny looks, a lot of jokes about, you know, stealing my kid's Lego and bringing it into work. But, you know, I got some gears, some levers, and I made this little thing and the mechanism worked. And it was great because, you know, I can hand it to someone else and they can turn the crank and watch it move. And it was tactile and they're like, oh, okay. Now they saw what I meant when I was trying to describe it. And they took their smartphone out and they videotaped it and they you know, the video got sent to other people by email, and so that spread, and then from then on the die was cast. I was the Lego guy at the office. So from then, you know, I got my calipers out and I measured the Lego, turned it into a 3D CAD model, and then from then it was a typical, you know, working in the virtual environment, a very typical project. But the neat thing was we went from there to a prototype like we usually do. We assembled a prototype right over there and the facility here, and it was great because the first time the technician hooked it up to power and turned the on button on, it cycled exactly like we hoped it would. Like there was no binding, it was a smooth motion, and so it was a smashing success because it's very unusual to get a first prototype to work that well right out of the box. And so it was such a success that we decided, you know, we should buy Lego for the office and so I don't have to bring mine in from home. And we can work through things like that on all the projects. So since then, I've had several projects, and a lot of them. I started out with the Lego, make a little model of it, even a simple model, take a video with the phone, and it goes from there. So this is the example that I made. I did not personally work on the minivan seat, but you know, if I was given a project like that, I might make a model like this. If you can imagine, that's the floor of the minivan, and this is obviously the second row seat. So, you know, I would cycle it by moving these levers like this, and then it disappears into the floor. And raise it back up again. And like I said, it's great because other people can try it out themselves. It's also great because if there's actual gravity working on it, and there's play in the system, like in a real environment, as opposed to the computer environment, which can sometimes be a little bit too forgiving. And so you can find out where you may have problem areas where you're going to have to focus on the development of this. And so it's been a great tool.